Have you seen this beetle? If you have, you've seen one of the most sought after invasive forest pests in North America. This is the Asian Longhorned Beetle. Look at this hole. This is feeding from the Asian Longhorned Beetle larvae. They can feed on trees in 14 different genera. Here in North America, it's mostly maples. They feed in and out of the wood, causing this thing to look like Swiss cheese. This causes branches to break, tops to drop, fell down like a giant spear right here into the ground. So here's part of it sticking up, and here's the rest of it. And if we look closely on here, right here, we've got Asian Longhorned Beetle damage. Here's an exit hole from where an adult crawled out. This is a really old egg site, another really old egg site, and this is pretty decomposed now, but if we still had some structure, you would see all sorts of larval galleries all throughout this thing. Maple is a huge part of the ecology of all these places. It is an important tree species that we need to protect. We found this beetle in South Carolina because a resident just up the road saw one on her porch that had been attracted to the light at night. She took a picture and sent it to her son, who just happened to be an entomologist. He recognized it immediately and said, "Ma, you gotta tell regulatory folks about this." She made the call, we checked it out. It was definitely Asian Longhorned Beetle. We will never know for sure how it got here. That being said, these beetles are not strong flyers. They're not gonna fly from state to state. We know that there's an RV park right next to the residential area where it was found. It more than likely got here in Firewood from another infestation. Behind me is our base of operations, the center of our quarantine zone. We've got federal folks, we've got state folks, we've got researchers, extension personnel. We have research going on. We're trying to figure out how this beetle operates. So there's pairs of beetles on here so we can learn about what they need when they wanna lay eggs and oviposit. We've got tents back here where we're collecting adults, and we're trying to figure out what sort of things about their biology can we learn and use to better manage and eventually eradicate this pest. Let's talk about the biology of ALB. This is an adult Asian Longhorned Beetle. She's got a black body with blue feet and a black and white striped antenna. It's a really neat beetle. They're very pretty. They're fairly good size. You can see she's over an inch long. It's called a starry sky beetle in China because of the white marks on a black background. Look kind of like a star, a bunch of stars in the sky. They don't fly a whole lot, but it's a really, really pretty beetle. This is one of the easiest life stages to identify. It's very picturesque. People take pictures of this all the time when they find them. And it's one of these things where we hope the general public, if you see one of these, please take a picture, send it to us, even better, collect it, and let's report it and see if we have Asian Longhorned Beetle in your area. These are egg niches after the adults mate. The female will chew this little divot in the log, and in some of those divots, she turns around and shoves an egg in there, and you can see there's probably one in there because there's a little hole. Looks like a needle was stuck in there. And so there's probably an egg in here. This egg will be in here for a few weeks, and then it will hatch, and that larva will start feeding on the phloem. That's the green living part of the tree. They'll feed on the phloem for a month or so, then the larva will turn and go straight inside the wood. This is when the Swiss cheesing happens. So this is when that larva feeds on the wood, meanders back and forth throughout that log, the branch, throughout the stem, and it will pupate in there probably in April of next year. So it stays inside the wood for about 8 to 10 months. A month later, the adults come out. You don't necessarily need to see an adult to identify ALB. There are two times in the larval period where it's fairly easy to see if your tree is infested. First, after the eggs hatch and the larvae start feeding on phloem, the tree oozes a black sap, which tends to drip down the tree and cause these really, really dark stains. Then later, as the larvae turn and go straight into the wood and feed there, you have wood shavings and sawdust gets pushed out of that hole, and it tends to rain down all over everything below it. We are in the Asian Longhorned Beetle quarantine zone here in Charleston County, South Carolina. A quarantine zone is a boundary we've drawn around the infested area, which means you cannot move material that might hold Asian Longhorned Beetles out of this area. Right now, we manage this beetle by simply removing the host. If there's an infested tree, it gets cut down, it gets chipped up, we grind that stump, and by removing that host, we remove that beetle. Here's how you can help. If you think you've seen a beetle, report it. We will send someone out, we will check out your report, we will look to see if there's Asian Longhorned Beetle, and we can take the appropriate action. Also, don't move firewood or any other infested material. This is likely how this thing got here in the first place, and it's likely how it moves around from place to place in other areas. So please, use locally sourced or heat-treated firewood.